Hello everybody. Mko salama? Weekend yenu ilikuwa vipi? Yangu ilikuwa fantama, gorgeous, spectacular. Ijafikia watu wengine wako kwa hii meza, lakini nasema tu yangu. Watafikia, watatuambia yao ilikuwaje. And we are canceling all the Monday blues because the hashtag today is Monday blessings. Welcome to the show. My name is Mikali Mary.
Hello, Chatspot Farm. How you're doing? I am doing great. I'm doing fantastic. I know I didn't have as much fun as some people. Yes, who will tell us exactly what they've been up to? But today we are celebrating Kobe Bryant because yesterday was his birthday. But today, now this is the first annual Kobe Bryant Day where we get to celebrate this iconic man because he was just more than an athlete for most kids and, you know, most people in the world, you know. So basically to just celebrate him today, I want to ask you guys, let's take a moment of silence for this man and his daughter Gianna. Yes, welcome to the show. My name is Nana Owiti.
Hello, nimewaletea salams kutoka kule pwani. Wajua lazima nizungumze hivi, wanielewa sio. Anyway guys, hi, how y'all doing? I hope you guys are as refreshed as I am. I mean, for those of you who do not know why I'm feeling this good, my Instagram is @JoyceMinor. Apo Instagram tuona ile mambo nilikuwa nafanya weekend. How was your weekend though? Of course, mnajua lazima nige Rudy, so it's nice. It's very nice to be back here with you guys. And as usual, we have a great show lined up for you. My name is JoyceMinor.
Hello. Umekuletea tanazi kitu tu.
Kunani?
Usiwe watu kama wengine hapo walisema kwa TV wanakuletea samaki.
Najaifika.
Uliona samaki na anyone
else? Wewe ulisikia wapi?
How was your weekend, guys?
Mine was
really nice.
Yeah, mine too.
Whatever, guys. So yeah. You know how we do this show. We have amazing stories lined up for you. And Joyce is not on that list. It's time for Pop Spot. Baby kidogo, Katerina. I don't know how that song starts, so
I wanna look at you, baby kidogo.
Wow, really, Katerina.
And that is our story today. We talked about this a while back. There were rumors flying around that 001 Governor Joho ana date yule Natalie Tewa. So we talked about it, and nobody came out to say ati, oh, we are dating or we are not dating. So we kept speculating. And now kulichacha zaidi when we saw a video of Governor Joho singing along to Baby Yelena Luka Chikidogo, the Katerina song. And then we saw a picture of Natalie Tewa captioned Baby Katerina. So guys were just like, hey, this is
one
it.
Plus one.
Yeah, you know, one plus two. One is a one.
001.
You know? But anyway, over the weekend, as he was talking to Mwalimu Churchill Kingangi, he mentioned this story. Of course, he expected to be asked this question about yeye na Natalie Tewa na kama kuna chochote kinaendelea. And this is what he had to say. Akasema, hiyo kitu imeniletea shida. Wacha tu. So nilikuwa naimba tu kwa raha zangu. I wanna look at you, baby kidogo. I think he sang there. And he continued to say, the thing is, even if you're a leader, you have a life. What is wrong if I spend 2 minutes to enjoy music? Because I'm still human and I am allowed to enjoy and live life. So I don't work 24/7. First, I do what I need to do. Then I also have to find time for myself. So then kama ametujibu, but
he said nothing. There's nothing, there's no answer he has answered there.
Yeah.
Ni story tu anatupeleka tu hivi.
But anasema kulikuwa na shida. Kama ilikuwa pengine, maybe just reading between the lines.
Exactly, that's what I'm doing, reading in between the lines.
Can so we say, what are you reading?
I am reading that kuna kitu hawatuambi.
Okay.
Yeah. But can we just acknowledge Mag story in Dubai.
Oh wow, Nana. Oh Mag.
So are we? Please let's just fly with allegedly over here.
Allegedly.
Alleged everything.
Yeah, she has allegedly secured the bag.
She did.
Allegedly.
Yeah. Okay, don't know them. But yeah, we just have to say like he's very stylish, this governor.
He's very
good for you.
Yeah.
001.
he likes to live the good life and he's not afraid to show it.
No, yeah.
So kudos to you.
Yeah.
And keep singing. Ilikuwa nzuri TikTok, I think.
But hey, that's how I knew that song.
Ata mimi.
Uko na joyo wimbo.
And speaking of bugging bugs, and let's talk about media personality Betty Kialo, who of course we talked about her when she lost her job and she didn't sign the, she signed the resignation papers at another local station, and then now she opened up a beauty parlor. Like, she's just having everything done, you know, she's just having it done by herself now. This is the story. She did an interview on her YouTube channel, which has really grown a huge big deal. So she was interviewing a guy called Jonathan Jackson of you know, we're making money moves. So there's this a condo that is coming up in Upper Hill. It's called 88 Nairobi, and it's gonna have like 44 floors.
Damn,
that's such a tall, high-end building. Okay, I'm sorry for doing this.
You are doing this a lot, and I love it.
You do, yeah. So basically, they were having a conversation about how this apartment is gonna look like, and apparently she has bagged herself one of the condos, which actually is worth 34 million Kenya shillings.
Hey.
Yes, and this is what you get, like, ukilipa hii, aka sign paper hapo, yeah, you know, you have to reserve, like, lazima ubook mapema, because it's not yet ready, it's gonna be ready in the next 3 years, so, na, lazima ulipe pia, like, 100k booking fee, that she has paid. Anywho, this is what you get when you order. You order for that building. How? Anywho, atani wasome. This is what you get. Get it. Okay, there. Fully self-contained building, 9-floor parking lot, VIP lounge inclusive of a bar area, Italian restaurant, solar heated 21-meter swimming pool, gym and spa, a helipad, and an aerial view of Kenya's capital city, Nairobi. Yes.
The
completion will take like 3 years.
Yes.
So you have like so enough time to pay
more
slowly.
Expensive after much, it's done.
Yeah.
For you to
at
get
your tiny off plan.
Yeah.
Right. Off plan. Yeah.
34 and million. Half. It's already been bought halfway.
What?
Yeah, people have money. Mkiongelelea watu wako na shida jiongelelea.
Ah, watu wako wapi?
Matakaje nao Joyce?
Na wanafanya nini? Ndio wapate hiyo pesa. Nataka tu kuongelesha nijue mahali wanatoa hii pesa.
Yeah.
We just need to have a talk.
Wow.
So it's like the tallest luxurious residential apartment in Africa, built by European standards. In Africa.
Is that that's the huge building that had a dispute a while ago? Watu wa, is it in Kileleshwa?
No, it's in Upper Hill.
Oh, okay. No, there's one that had a dispute because apparently if you build such a big, tall building, you have to take into consideration sewerage, water and all of that stuff. And
yeah,
some neighborhoods, as it is already, are suffering with, you know, water and all of those things.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't, maybe Upper Hill has a better plan for the sewerage and stuff. Yeah. Because I remember there's a building that had, because that's, it's great to hear that there's a 44-story apartment complex being built, but you have to take into consideration
all these
the water,
things.
Sewerage,
yeah.
How many people are going to be living there, you know. But good
for you.
Must be nice. But let me take you on to some sad news. TV King Larry King went on to social media to let people know about the loss of his children. He lost his son and his daughter within 3 weeks in July and August consecutively. Yes, so he went on to social media to say, "It is with sadness and a father's broken heart that I confirm the recent loss of two of my children, Andy King and Chaya King. Both of them were good and kind souls, and they will be greatly missed. Andy passed away unexpectedly of a heart attack on July 28th, and Chaya passed on August 20th, only a short time after having been diagnosed with lung cancer." He continues to say, "Losing them feels so out of order. No parent should have to bury a child. My family and I thank you for your outpouring kind sentiments and well wishes. In this moment, we need a little time and privacy to heal. I thank you all for respecting that."
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, he's lived a long
time. He's 85 years old.
You know.
Yeah, and he couldn't go for the funeral because he's recovering from a stroke that he had.
Stroke. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's really
it's a lot
sad.
Of bad you news leave, for one family.
You leave that long, fully, and then you lose your children.
Yeah. Kwanzaa in a span of like 3 weeks.
Yeah, that's heartbreaking. 3 weeks,
yeah. And I think those were probably the oldest ones.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
It's very sad.
Our condolences
to the king family.
Yeah.
Yeah.